invite you to take a quick look with us at some of the changes the years have brought.
The normal school was quite small when we started, just 247 students and 18 faculty members. As the needs of our state and students changed, our mission expanded.
Improving teaching and learning is the bedrock of programs all across this campus. We established a tradition of excellence as we became a community of learners that engages its students, faculty, staff, and alumni in a common pursuit of excellence. As we look at where we are today, we'll see some of the ways we've responded to the inevitable challenges that change and progress bring.
Before, my impression anyway, when I sort of got to MTSU, it was more of a southern university, meaning that a lot of local people from, you know, these small towns around here, near Murfreesboro, and guys that had gone and get their degree came back to work on their farms, etc. So that type of thing was prevalent. Then you had people coming from other areas, from New York, from Chicago, from schools on the West Coast, etc., coming in to the university. And I think that mixture helped spread the identity.
We're on the cutting edge here in Tennessee with the recent Race to the Top acclaim that we've received. We're in the national spotlight. And because the state's in the national spotlight, that's put the spotlight on universities and public schools. And we're responding to that. For example, within a couple of years, all of our teacher ed students will spend a year of residency during their senior year out in the public schools. So the amount of time they're in a college classroom is going down, the amount of time they're in a public classroom is going up. So it's that type of reflection, the people that I met as an undergraduate going to school here, my early years of teaching here about 20-something years ago, looking at the growth and thinking that, hey, we've done okay.
And the university has grown tremendously, not just in size, but in the quality of the programs and the facilities on campus. The faculty here are second to none, and the research that's being done is both interesting and varied, cutting-edge type research addressing some of the most significant problems that the world faces today. There's a significant underappreciation of MTSU's role, not just in Murfreesboro and Middle Tennessee, but even beyond that, the international aspects of the university. And we've made some significant improvements. The new MTSU magazine, for example, I think is a fantastic addition to that advertising.
Although we started with only 4 buildings, today we're approaching 140. Being sure that students have good places to study, learn, exercise, reflect, compete, and live means that the campus is never static. MTSU is fortunate to have received state money to cover the planning, design, and infrastructure for a much-needed science building. Now we await state funds for construction. As campus needs have increased, MTSU has successfully used federal, county, city, private, and student-generated funds to address space and facility requirements. Private funding made possible the Paul W. Martin Honors Building, additions to the Case and Kennedy Nursing Building, creation of a distinctive Veterans Memorial, and construction of a new stadium and press box at Smith Baseball Field. Student-voted fees resulted in additions to the Student Recreation Center, an effective roundabout to keep traffic moving, and a new student union that's under construction. A federal grant made possible our unique Naked Eye Observatory. The City of Murfreesboro and the Chamber of Commerce partnered with us to build a new track and soccer stadium. Other recent changes include renovating Todd Hall, making extensive resident hall improvements, and a new education building,